It's not about me, as if you should do things my way. You alone are God, and I surrender. It's all about you. It's not about me, as if you should do things my way. You alone are God, and I surrender to your ways.
To the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord all the earth. Sing praises unto God. Let us bow together in prayer. Let us pray. Lord, you are indeed worthy of a new song. So come to us, O Lord, as the Holy Spirit, and inspire our singing, our meditating, and our thinking as we spend a few moments to be inspired by your word and your love in our lives. Be with us now, we pray, through the precious name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Reading from Psalm 59, verse 1, and then continuing from verses 14 to 17. Save me from my enemies, my God. Protect me from those who attack me. My enemies come back in the evening, snarling like dogs as they go about the city. Like dogs roaming about for food and growling if they do not find enough. But I will sing about your strength every morning, and I will sing aloud for your constant love. You have been a refuge for me, a shelter in my time of trouble. I will praise you, my defender. My refuge is God, the God who loves me. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God for his word. Amen.
Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts be acceptable in thy sight. Amen. When last did your heart burst out in song unto God? When last did your lips overflow with praise? I'm not talking about the singing some of us do in church. That kind of, what a friend we have. And no, not that kind of lame singing for Jesus. I mean the kind of singing to God that captivates our hearts and our minds and fixes them on heavenly hope. This kind of singing, friends, has power. In the psalm that we read today, the psalmist is deeply troubled. The psalmist is surrounded by enemies, and he describes them as dogs. Not the beautiful dogs that we have in our homes and love today, but wild animals that roam for food and growls and snaps when they have not devoured enough. There are times in life when we may feel like the psalmist. There are times where we may feel attacked and unsafe. There are moments like the psalmist where we feel unsure about our future ahead of us, or we may be fearful of what our lives could become. Or, like the psalmist, we could be afraid of losing our lives. Let's be honest. We live in a society rampant with crime and violence, filled with wicked dogs who take advantage of others. The rich and the powerful are oppressing the poor. Our young women are living in fear of the dogs that kidnap us and sell our bodies. Research even shows that Trinidad is one of the main transit points for global human trafficking. Sometimes these experiences of violence and fear come and meet us in our own homes and from those we trusted as our family and our friends. But in all this anguish and all this fear, the psalmist chooses to sing. Singing doesn't get rid of the dogs and it doesn't get rid of the enemies. Singing doesn't magically erase and solve all the psalmist's problems. But singing reminds the psalmist of who God is. And the psalmist is very specific about what he chooses to sing about. He says he will sing about the strength of the Lord. He will sing aloud about the constant love of our God. Then, when the psalmist sings about the goodness of God, it reminds him of his worth in the eyes of God, that he is loved by God. So friends, like the psalmist, let us sing. Not because it solves all of our problems, but because it reminds us of who God is and how loved we are by God. Throughout history, people who faced common struggles joined in common songs, songs that gave hope and strength to carry on fighting for justice. For example, there's a beautiful hymn, "Lift Every Voice and Sing." It's a powerful piece that became known as the American Black Anthem, especially during the Black Power movement. This song speaks about our unity in pain, the difficult road of oppression that we have had to endure, but most of all, the God of love who has led us into the light of freedom. So friends, let us sing. Don't be afraid, just sing out to God. Let us sing of the strength of our God that triumphs over our pain and will give us freedom. Let us sing to remember who God is and who we are in the love of God. Let us join with those before us who sang with hope through their pain. God of our weary years, God of our silence. Thou who hast brought us thus far on our way, Thou who hast by Thy might led us into the light, keep us forever in the path, we pray. In the name of the Triune God, Amen. Let us pray. Lord, in all seasons of life, You have given us the gift of song. Help us, O Lord, to turn to You and to sing out a song of Your strength, whether we are happy on the mountaintop or whether we traverse through the depth of valleys and death. Help us, O Lord, through our singing to glorify You as we remember Your strength, Your love, and Your faithfulness to Your people. So hear this as we offer this prayer through the precious name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Journey each day, may
And now, may the Lord bless you and keep you, and may the Lord walk with you and give you a new song, now and forever. Amen.